ACE really shows its power when you combine it with the module database. Now, the module database and ACE work well together, and in fact, we refer as ACE to being module database aware. That means that ACE can not only see but also use the aliases and properties that you set up in the module database in its calculations. ACE can programmatically access these aliases and properties and use them as functional pieces or variables in the certain calculations. We add the module database to the ACE calculation via contexts. And a context is simply another term for the path to a module. And so if the context were a path to a certain unit, and that unit had five aliases, we could then use the aliases in the calculations instead of specific tag names. Now what this does is it allows us to have multiple layers and levels of modules, and if any of the layers share the same aliases or share the same properties, we can then use those in the calculations. And as we talked about before, we ideally want to design a calculation that will be designed once but used in many different contexts, and we're going to show you an example of that in a few moments. So the goal in all of your ACE calculations is to try as give as many options as possible to the person using the ACE manager using the Pi module database, so you don't need to go back into the application and recompile. So for example, if you're going to do a calculation on two different tags, and you can build a module database structure where those tags share the same alias but in different modules, you can create the calculation not using tag name but instead using alias name, and then allowing the user to add or remove specific modules to add or remove those calculations from the list of the calculations in the executable. And we're going to show you how to do that in a few moments. In this demonstration of using ACE with the module database, we're obviously going to have to set up a module database structure to use with our calculations. And what I've done is I have, using the techniques talked about in earlier lessons on this CBT, I've built out a structure where I have a base module called Site1, and underneath that I have four modules, and I've simply called them Unit1 through Unit4. Every unit is identical in the fact that it has an alias called flow, and it's got some properties, namely one called design. And design we're going to use as a sort of target specification. We want this flow to ideally be this number. This is the number where the unit operates most efficiently. And for all of the other units, I have the exact same structure. The only difference I have made in the units is that they have different design numbers, and we'll see why that is in a few moments. And what I've done is I've taken one of my tags and I have propagated it. I have taken my CDT158 tag and simply copy and pasted it, altering only the one of the location numbers, so I get slightly different values. And I've taken that tag and I've propagated it to three other times, so I've got four tags total. And the reason I have four tags, CDT158, CDT258, 358, and 458, is because I want to have one unique tag for each one of my units. So you notice that unit 1 has CDT158 and unit 2 has CDT258. Now what I'm going to do in this example, and we'll step through all of the structures, is I'm going to first design a calculation not using tag name but by using alias, and the calculation is going to compare the current value from the design number, and it's going to report its value to a string tag, and the string tag we do need to create, so I'm going to have to create a string tag for this. And I'm going to create a new tag, and I'm going to call this CDT underscore output underscore log. And what we're going to do is we're going to take this tag, and this will be a string tag, and we're going to take that tag and write to it the result of our calculations. Let me save this tag in the system. And so what I want to do is I want to go to, for all of my tags, I'm going to compare their current values to the design value, and I'm going to write a message to that string tag based upon the result of the calculation. Now I'm only going to write the calculation once in ACE, but I'm going to refer through all of the units of my module database, and it's going to pick up the flow alias and perform the calculation on it. So I can write one calculation and I will ultimately apply it to four separate tags using their aliases.